in sports without gurus. For now, though, but TWY in studio, guys. We're gonna talk fashion. We're gonna talk Chan Lee. Check this out.
When she came to Joburg, she got a bit of swag and goes with the name of Miss TWY. Now, at the tender age of 24, African beautiful garments. How she got all of this to stand up as a business and now on her way swiftly to the top as a successful designer. Malavi,
how are you?
When Nosa Mbukela Kalo?
No, you know what? We'll do it on the next season.
Next season, yes? You'll hook
it's
me up.
It's me and you.
It's me and you. Let's talk a little bit about your introduction to Diaparo.
Okay, my aunt was a fashion designer.
Oh, okay.
And my grandmother was a fashion designer as well. So it's in the blood.
It's in the blood?
Yes.
Okay, but I get a fashion designer has evolved.
Yes. Now, I've taken my aunt's style. She loved African fabric.
Okay.
So now I'm interpreting that into modern day art.
Okay. Deciding, I mean, when did the decision that okay, you go and try as a living? You don't have a rot, but what can you rock?
So I had a needle at the age of 9.
Okay,
and I was sewing cushions with my hands. And then my grandmother noticed that I see something, we're connected.
Yeah.
And then she bought me my first sewing machine at 9, hers. And then at the age of 15 years, she bought me my very first sewing machine. So that's when I started.
Because she noticed sort of
yes,
you were really good at it.
She saw it.
What were some of the conversations that I did? No, once her. Like, I want you to give me a typical day. If what was the conversation? What was it like?
Like, I'd make her Mother's Day presents, that cushions that say Happy Mother's Day, Nihar. And then she'd notice that you made this, yes. And then she taught me how to do it properly.
Yeah.
And then I also went to go work with my aunt for a couple of seasons to see how you. So properly,
yeah.
And then after that, at the age of 15, I went to school.
Oh wow! Let's talk about the idea of royalty, which is something that's very close to your heart. How
yeah.
did that come about?
Okay, so it's a long story. My grandfather is of royal blood.
Okay.
So that's where we got the Royal Fashion Show name, and
okay.
we got like even my name, Twilight. It's like
yeah.
royalty.
Yeah. I love that, but I also want to look at you. I mean, this, what you're wearing in itself just says, it caught my attention. But I want to see some of your friends that you brought along all draped in your garments. Let's start with the first gentleman furthest to us. Beautiful. Let's talk about that. That piece is...
That is more of your formal look.
Yeah.
Now he's wearing it with a white suit trouser, and
yeah.
it's got a shoulder detail that is my signature weaving.
Okay.
So.
Oh, and that is Zaga.
Yes.
Okay. Okay.
So you can wear it anywhere.
Yeah.
Weddings, church, anywhere.
Yeah. No, if brother comes with this one at church.
No, he's a pastor.
Is he a pastor?
Yes, he is.
Like in real life.
Yes.
Oh my God! What is the chance? I'm finished. I'm going to figure it. All right, and my lovely lady in the beautiful orange. It's popping. It's oh,
it's
is
very
that a hoodie.
Brave. Yes, that is a.
Come on, wear with it. Oh. For the days, for the days.
And then
days.
She's wearing that with a pocketed skirt, so it's got hidden pockets, the skirt.
Okay. Oh, look at that. I love the, oh, I'm going to probably call it wrong. The detail in the front. God, I use that zigzag because they cross over each
it's
other.
Weaving.
It's
That's
weaving.
That's my signature.
So weaving is always part of something that we will see.
Yes, and then I also have like little pockets.
Okay. Talk to me about the hoodie.
So you can wear that when you wear the hoodie,
yeah.
it becomes casual.
Yeah. So that para kamo matubs kika yana kaposeta yana
anything,
okay.
anything. Even if you want to wear it with a suit, if you're like as brave as me,
yeah,
you can.
Okay. And then just pop it up there.
Yes.
At the
and
top.
Then she can wear it also like as a shawl. But when you look at it from the front, it does look like some sort of shawl, like
oh,
a scarf.
Oh my goodness.
And then when she turns around, she's like, oh,
there's a big surprise there at the
yes.
back. That's absolutely beautiful. Oh, do your thing, girl. Looking very nice. I love it. I see the shawl idea.
Yes.
How we feel? Garanto. Sana marenda. Tentacular. Garanto. Brothers. Yeah, so now he looks very casual, like.
Yes, now that is smart casual. He's wearing it with a smart casual top, and then he's wearing that with a jumpsuit. Now the top has a shoulder detail.
Yeah.
And it's got the African, hidden African, because we are coconuts on the outside, but we're African inside.
Okay, okay, yes. Okay. Oh, so this is a jumpsuit.
Yes, it's got a front.
So I'm sure
detail.
He can wear this differently, like
definitely.
Put another t-shirt inside, maybe more African prints to make it pop. Signature pieces.
Yes.
And we see that happening, I mean, with all the looks.
Yes.
How important is having that touch?
Now, everyone that is like my client and who has worked with me before have noticed my handwriting. I call it my handwriting.
Okay.
In 22 mile iyabonakala.
All right.
So you get it with the signature weaving or the small pocket in front. Now the jumpsuit has a pocket in front.
Why is the pocket in front, Lola? Okay.
So when he can wear it like that, you can still put your phone, and then when he flips it, there's still a pocket on the outside.
Okay,
so it's
cool.
Functional.
So pockets and weaving are your signature.
Yes, ma'am.
Jeez, man, you are an absolute inspiration. We wish you all the best. Thank you so much for hanging out with us right here on Fashion on Fleek. It's Miss Twy Light or Twy, right?
Yes,
just Twy. If you know her like me, you can just call her Miss Twy. So for a quick ad break, I'm Mzansi.